Today's topic, 22 signs of a toxic relationship. Today I want to share the signs with you that you are in a toxic relationship. And if you are, then you have to get out. Don't even think about staying for another week or for another month or telling yourself over and over again, he will change. It's just the way it is. That's how he is. I still love him. It's okay. I can deal with it. Stop making excuses for his behavior and start taking action in a way that you can finally change your life to the better. Because you should never be in a relationship that makes you feel drained, unhappy, resentful, lonely, and exhausted. And if you are in this position right now, then I invite you to click on the second link in the description or to go directly to gethimkeephim.com/Skype and to work with me in a Skype coaching session. I've helped amazing women to leave toxic relationships, to finally get rid of their loser boyfriends, and to then in the process attract an incredible man. Because you deserve an incredible man, you deserve a relationship that makes you happy, and you deserve a wonderfully fulfilling relationship that is anything but toxic. So if you want to work with me, then you can go to gethimkeephim.com/Skype. So yes, no matter how painful it will be, and no matter how long you've already stayed in this relationship, probably for way too long, you have to get out of it. And the following signs will show you why. And the first sign is that he's jealous, but he's not jealous in a romantic way or in a normal way. It's way beyond normal. And to be honest, I'm very critical about this idea that jealousy is a sign of love. Because if you really trust someone, I mean, you just don't have any reason to be jealous. And if you didn't give him any reason to be jealous, but he's constantly jealous, he always wants to know who you go out with. He doesn't want you to go out with a male friend. He gets jealous whenever you just talk to another man, even if it's, for example, a male colleague of yours. Then this is a sign that he's very insecure and that your relationship is toxic, and especially if he gets aggressive or angry when you just look at another man or when you just talk to another man. These are all signs that you should be very, very careful. And do you know that song? Every step you take, I'll be watching you. And I know I can't sing, but when you really think about this song, it's very, very creepy. It's crazy that it turned out to be one of those romantic songs, even though the singer, I think it was Sting back then with his band, he actually said in an interview that the meaning of this song is not romantic at all. But what if your boyfriend or your husband shows exactly this behavior? Every step you take, he's watching you. He's stalking you, he's controlling you, he tries to make sure that you don't go anywhere without him. These are all signs of a toxic relationship. And when he wants to control your life, this can be very, very dangerous. And if that happens to you, you have to get out. If you, for example, start dating a guy and he seems to be so open-minded, but then suddenly, once you are in a relationship, I don't want you to go out without me. I don't want you to go to a bar with your friends. I don't want you to meet this friend because she's a bad influence. I don't want you to do this. I don't want you to do that. If this is your life right now, ask yourself, do you really want to live like that? You have the birthright to be free, so don't allow any man to restrict your freedom. And what if he keeps score of everything you do and then uses it against you? This is also a sign of toxic behavior. Let's say, for example, 5 years ago, you said something to him because you were a little bit tipsy and he didn't like it. You made a joke and he didn't think it's funny. And now every time you have an argument, he says, "You remember 5 years ago when you said this to me?" This is a clear sign that this is a toxic relationship. And drama is created out of thin air. Have you ever been in a relationship where drama is the norm? Where every day there's a new thing, a new drama, a new event, and just drama all over the place. And this is one of the most obvious signs, but unfortunately, because of our cultural conditioning, it's also one of the least obvious signs. Because so many people nowadays, and both men and women fall into this trap, believe that drama is a sign of love. Because we are so used to it from reality TV, from movies, from songs, oh, if there's love, everybody has to suffer. There has to be drama. There has to be gunshots. There has to be poisoning. There has to be tears. And oh my God. And this is so, so wrong. It's so wrong on so many levels. Just because you see a movie where everybody's dying and then in the end they kiss each other doesn't mean that your life should be like that. I mean, the reason why I'm so happy in the relationship with my girlfriend is because it's so non-dramatic. I don't even remember the last time I had an argument with her. I mean, yes, sometimes we disagree on something, that's completely normal, but we still talk about it with love and respect. It's never been at a point where she throws cups at me and I scream at her and I throw the pasta at her or whatever. That didn't happen because we live a relationship that is completely free of drama. And believe me, I've been in relationships in the past that were full of drama. And yes, it was also my fault. It's always about two. But when you are the one who allows that drama, I mean, then he will create more and more drama. And he's playing with your fear of abandonment. I mean, when you love somebody really, really strongly, then there's always a little bit of fear of abandonment. And if he always plays with this fear, then this fear gets bigger. If he, for example, says, if you don't do this, I will leave you. Or if you do that, I will leave you. And he always threatens to leave you. In this case, the best thing you can do is to leave him. And the cheating continues right after he promised to change. If that happens to you, then you need to get out. And if you want me to help you to get out of this relationship, if you want me to help you to then attract a relationship that makes you happy because you deserve such a relationship, then you can click on the second link in the description or go to gethimkeephim.com/skype. And what if he makes you responsible for how he feels? This is also a sign of being in a toxic relationship. Let me share an example with you from my own life. I love my girlfriend very, very much. The love I feel for her is very strong. And that's why I'm always worried about her well-being. I always want to make sure that she's safe. And especially in the beginning of our relationship, I was very, very worried, which then created negative emotions because I was so focused on keeping her safe. And then I decided, okay, I have to work on these emotions. Not once did I say, you are a terrible person because you make me feel worried, or you make me feel worried. I never said that because I'm responsible for my own emotions in the same way as you are responsible for your emotions and he is responsible for his emotions. But if he blames you for how he feels, then we have a problem. And speaking of problems, problems are just pushed under the bed without ever working on them. What? You have an argument, a disagreement, a problem? Nah, let's just push it all under the bed and hide them in the closet. We don't need to deal with that. And he uses the don't you love me pressure. I mean, I have to be honest, both men and women sometimes use this. Men often use it because they want to have fun in the bedroom and they say don't you love me when you are, for example, not in the mood. Women, on the other hand, sometimes use it for commitment and say, why don't you propose to me? Don't you love me? Both actions are, at least in my experience and in my opinion, very, very toxic. If you love someone, you should never pressure them in any way. And what if he shares secrets with other people that he shouldn't share? Let's say you tell him something very, very intimate, very private, and he shares it with his friends or even with your friends. Then there's a problem. And what if, and that's a very extreme case, in this case, you should leave him right away. And you might even want to take legal action. If he records you without consent, revenge, pee, and it ends with a orn, is unfortunately very, very widespread and very popular. If that happens in your relationship, then you need to take action. And if he messes up, but you are the one who gets blamed for it, he messes up, it's clearly his fault, but he says to you, it's your fault. Then, well, you need to get out. And this poor man, he's always the victim. Oh, it's always your fault. He's the victim. Oh, he's, the whole world is against him. Oh, his parents are against him. His employer is against him. Oh, he's always complaining and whining. Do you really want to date such a man? And you excuse his behavior. And yes, I want to share an example with you, even though a lot of people consider Sharon Osbourne and Ozzy Osbourne as the dream couple, but I once watched an interview, I think it was on the TV show 60 Minutes, where she said, one time he tried to strangle me, and you know, he said, we decided that you have to die, and he almost succeeded, so I almost died. And then the interviewer asked Sharon, why didn't you leave? Ah, you know, he's an addict. And in this moment, I thought to myself, well, I mean, yes, I'm happy for them that they are together for such a long time. But I mean, if your boyfriend tries to strangle you, no matter if he's on drugs or not, then you need to get out and you shouldn't say, oh, well, he's an addict. And what if he hits on your friends and is not ashamed of it? Then he's clearly not the kind of guy who you can trust, and you also shouldn't trust him. Instead, you should allow him to hit on your friends, and you should give him this permission while you're walking out of his life. And he always wants you to give, but he never gives you anything. No support, he doesn't listen, he always expects you to give, 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 and the only thing that he does is take, take, take. This is not a relationship that is based on equality and love and mutual support. But if you ever meet a man who's worthy of your love and worthy of your support and who wants to be in a relationship with you that is based on equality, on love and support, then you can make this man obsessed with you. And if you want to have this power, then you can go to gethimkeephim.com/obsession, or you click on the first link in the description. And you are judged for every move you make. This is also a clear sign of a toxic relationship. You are judged for your past, you are judged for the experiences you had in the past, you are judged for how you talk, how you laugh, how you walk. It's just a never-ending train of judgment. Then get out. And if he feels threatened by your success, that's also a clear sign that this relationship is anything but healthy. I, for example, I'm very proud of the success that my girlfriend achieves. But a lot of my Skype coaching clients who were trapped in toxic relationships and who I've helped to get out of toxic relationships, they told me that the man in their life, the man they were in a relationship with, felt threatened by their success. And then this is a clear sign that it's a toxic relationship and that you're dating a very insecure man. And he makes you feel unworthy of his love. He always communicates to you, either directly or indirectly, that you are so lucky to be with him because he makes more money than you, and he's more handsome than you, and he's more successful than you, and he's just better because blah 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 blah. This is always based on insecurity. A confident man would never do that, but an insecure man who wants you to be trapped with him in this toxic relationship will do that. And that's why, yes, you guessed it, you should get out of this relationship. And you never know when he's lying and when he's telling the truth, because there are just so many lies. And you feel lonely and so uncomfortable in your relationship. And let me tell you this, you deserve a wonderful relationship. You deserve a man who makes you happy. You deserve a fulfilling relationship that is based on love, support, and trust. You should never feel lonely and uncomfortable and unhappy in a relationship. And if you enjoyed watching this video, if you liked it, please give it a big thumbs up and leave a comment in the comment section below. Share your opinion, share your thoughts. I would love to hear from you. And I would love it even more if you would hit the subscribe button and smash that notification bell so that you get notified whenever I release a new video for you. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch this video.